Hey guys! I finally got this game working. I've been trying to for ages. Let's hope it is still going. I know I said that there would be no Christmas themed videos after Christmas, but I've learned that in the Netherlands, this is still considered Christmas, so I'm cheating slightly. And I am playing Jazz Jackrabbit Christmas Chronicles. Now, this game, not specifically the Christmas version, but this game was basically my childhood. I grew up playing the original on DOS, so I'm aging myself here, but that's okay. And I absolutely loved it. It got to the point, I had like the shareware version, and it got to the point where I knew all the secrets and could do this literally with my eyes closed. I am not that good anymore. I have not played in years, but I was having issues with this game when I was trying to play it earlier in the Christmas holidays. For you guys, but I finally fixed the bug and got my recording software working, so this is very exciting for me. I don't sound super excited, but I am. So, as you can tell, as usual with gaming videos that I do, this is an old game. Says this was released in 99, so it's been a very long time, but it is still probably my favorite platformer. I absolutely love Jazz Jackrabbit, both 2 and 1, and this was a special Christmas release. It was actually only released in Europe, I learned later. They had a different Christmas special for North America, so this one actually, I think I've only played once or twice, because I would have downloaded it now that it's, I think, basically freeware. Oh yeah, this is annoying. They didn't quite space it correctly in the level design, so you have to jump. But anyway, as you may or may not be able to tell, this game, or this entire series of games, is based on the idea of the Aesop's fable, Tortoise and the Hare. So almost everything you fight is a turtle, and you are the hare. In previous renditions of the game, in the original rendition, you could play as the character I'm playing right now, Jazz Jackrabbit. And in later renditions, so in Jazz Jackrabbit 2, you could also play as his brother Spaz, who has different abilities. And in this one, you can also play as Lori, who's a character, female character, I believe they just added for the purpose of this Christmas special, because I've never seen her again or before. So, oops, I didn't mean to do that. So yeah, she's a female rabbit that you can play as. And in most of the games, if not all, your goal is to save Eva Longears, who is Jazz's, like, I guess his girlfriend. She's kind of the princess of the world. I think probably since this was made in, like, the early 90s, there's also kind of like a weird space theme going on, so you're technically going to different planets whenever you go to a new level. At least in the original, I think they kind of dropped it for Jazz 2, but regardless. I think the Eva Longears is supposed to be the princess of their world, Keratopia. And the evil guy is known as Devon Shell. And he is a turtle who is determined to capture Princess Longears and kind of like take over Keratopia, make the bunnies miserable. So your job as Jazz Jackrabbit, hero of the realm of Keratopia, is to save Eva, get the girl, defeat the evil baddie, win the day. Classic stuff. In Jazz... Oh, I guess you had this in Jazz 1, too. Huh, that's confusing. You had this in the original installment and in Jazz Jackrabbit 2, which I'm currently playing a rendition of. You can gather gems along the way, and I can't remember their significance. But, yeah, you can gather gems, and those give you extra points. The other thing that you'll probably have noticed that I've been gathering is different kinds of weapons. Now, I'm not using them right now because I'm pretty decent at the game, generally speaking, if I do say so myself, and you need certain weapons to get through certain types of blocks, as I'm using the TNT as we speak. So, I save them for that, instead of using them on little enemies that I can take out pretty easily without using special weapons. So, I also save them for the boss, because there will be a boss fight. Yeah. Now we get a huge gem. Whee! And, yeah. And like I said, it's just a really fun platformer. Absolutely, like I said, like obsessively loved this as a kid. It was the best, according to me. This one and One Must Fall was the other one. Now, I've never been able to get that to work again. But if anyone knows how to... excuse me, I'm losing my voice. If anyone knows how to get it working on DOSBox or something, please let me know, because One Must Fall was my other favorite DOS era game when I was a kid, and I always love playing those games again. Oops. I need a little secret if you go backwards. And another one. So, yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot for me to talk about in terms of gameplay here. It's a basic kind of shooter platformer. So you have Jazz, the main character, and you have special blocks that you can either shoot or use kinetic energy to blow up, meaning you like run into them really fast. Or you have enemies to take out. Don't get hit by the enemies or you'll lose hearts. Hearts can be regained with carrots, because you're a bunny. You have some pretty interesting level design as well. It's just an early platformer that was kind of a... From what I understand, it was actually considered a classic, but I only know my husband as the other person who played this as a kid. So I don't know exactly among whom it was considered classic, apart from my own family, myself. But I think it actually sold pretty well. I mean, it sold enough to come out with a sequel, so. And I will warn you in advance, I will try my best, but I will definitely not be as successful as usual talking throughout this. Because I don't know about you, but I find platformers take a lot more of my mental faculties than turn-based strategies, because I have to react much faster and consistently, as opposed to turn-based, where I can kind of pause, take my time to think, and take the time to talk as well. So. Oops. Woo! Thankfully, the palms don't actually do any damage. But yes, I'm very happy that this is finally working. I was trying for weeks, and there was always some kind of problem. So it was either, it was a problem with, oops, there's a one up there I want. Yeah, it was either a problem with the recording, so the actual software that I used to record wouldn't work, or it was a problem with the game itself. So I think I mentioned this in an earlier video. I was permanently stuck running. So I was doing this game basically on like a permanent high speed, which is problematic to say the least, because you're already going relatively fast. But I can demonstrate for you what was happening. So I don't use the run button much, but it was like this constantly. So I couldn't go any slower than this. And when Jazz is running, he has worse, you don't have as much control. So that's like anything, whoops, forgot to switch. It's like anything going high speed. It's harder to stop, harder to turn, easier to lose control. Ooh, Sugar Rush. Now this I will. Sugar Rush is cool. If you gather enough candies in the level, you can just run into things and they won't hurt you. Which is kind of cool. But I think there was a secret up there that I wanted to get. Ah, yes, you have maximum 99 of any kind of weapon. So once you have 99, you can't get any more. Oh, there's a 1-up. Perfect. Alrighty. And I have customized the controls. As you can probably hear, I'm using the keyboard. I'm trying to be quiet, I really am, but there's only so much I can do. I find the like initial keyboard setup, if you are someone who wants to play this game, the initial keyboard setup makes no sense. It's like you have your hands on the arrow keys, but your arms have to be almost crossed over to be able to use it, because it has like enter as your jump, I think, and then space as your shoot, and yeah, it just really isn't intuitive. So if you are gonna get this game or play any of the Jazz installations, I thoroughly recommend customizing the setup for yourself, because it's really weird if you don't. At least I find. And I have to play this in windowed mode to get it to work, so I hope you guys see it in more of like a full screen type situation. And I've also been, I don't know if you've noticed, I've been getting kind of like these kind of, they look like the basic gun, and these are called rapid fires. So when I very first started playing this, I would have to press the button a lot, press the shoot, the fire button a lot, in order to fire consistently. But now I can just hold the button down and it goes without me having to press it a bunch of times. So that should also make it quieter. I'll just go down here and see, there's a bunch of them, the rapid fire. And rapid fire makes it just much more convenient. Oops. Whoops, why does it keep switching to those? I must be hitting the button without realizing it. Now, you'll notice I can't get through those kind of, those blocks over there for the green gems. And that's because you have a different character, Spaz. You see how I'm jumping really high right here? He has a different ability that allows him to kick to the side, and that kick to the side ability would allow me to get those gems over there. So you can also play this game co-op. Husband is still asleep, so I won't be playing co-op today, but maybe in the future. We'll see what happens. We'll have to get our old joystick working, if that's the case. I remember when I was a kid, I used to play this game with one of my best friends. And to this day, I don't know how we did it, but we managed to both play on the same keyboard, which was like crazy. We had some kind of wild configuration where I was on the right-hand side of the keyboard and she was on the left. And we would play these games using the same keyboard because I didn't have a USB joystick at that time. And I do have one now, but it's kind of out of commission. Last time we tried it, it wasn't working, so I might have to get a new one. But some co-op gameplay might be fun in the future. Whoa, poop. I missed them. Woohoo! The volume down really low for me, but I'm not sure how low it is for you. Usually I keep it quite low, but hopefully it's not too loud, and hopefully the mic is picking up correctly. So it's, all my settings are good. It's really early in the morning when I'm recording, so I'm a little bit scatterbrained. let's go up. Can actually go two different ways with this one. So I'll take the upper route. I'll take the high road. Ooh, new kind of weapon. I think those are really good against the boss, if I remember correctly. He's weak to those. Oops. Back here, you. Now, I've done this game many times, chances are I'm never going to actually die. Like, I'll lose a couple hearts, but I won't have to restart the level. But normally when you restart the level, you lose all the accumulated weapons and rapid fire, and you basically have to start with less. But as I said, I can't remember the last time I actually had to do that, so I don't think you need to worry about it this time either. I'm a little out of practice, but not that out of practice. Oh, let's see what's down here. Oh, interesting. Okay. Well, let's break these anyway. There we go. I'm not really in short supply of TNT to begin with. And let's get the little secret thingy over here. Perfect. Also, my computer is being extremely loud. I can hear it very clearly, but hopefully you're not having the same issue. Ah, there is a way to get up there, but I forget how. Maybe it's from... Nope. Ooh, Sugar Rush. Nice. So yeah, Sugar Rush, you're invulnerable. You can just run into things, everything explodes. It's very nice. Whee. I guess Sugar Rush would be the equivalent of the star in a Mario game. Ooh, that was stupid. Oh well. Like I said, a little out of practice, but not too out of practice. Hmm. Maybe sometime I'll do the actual Jazz Jackrabbit games, either one or two, so you can see the actual storyline. For instance, it's the Advent series. I wanted to do the Christmas version. But, yeah, of course there are other, there's the original as well. And I think that one I have found on DOSBox successfully before. And actually got it to work. So maybe in the future I'll do that one. We'll see. Now, I will either play until the first boss, or until an hour has gone by, whichever happens first. I think the first boss will show up for an hour, which is good, because then I'll have more time to make some other videos to catch up. So how's your guys' Christmas been, or Hanukkah, or Kwanzaa, or whatever it is, Festivus, whatever it is that you celebrate? You can let me know in the comments. Mine was pretty quiet. We're in the Netherlands now, of course, and both our families are still in Canada, mine and husband's. So we didn't really have anyone visiting, or we didn't do anything special. We had brunch in the morning before church service, and both husband and I are musicians, so we played for the service as well. But after that, we pretty much just hung out at the apartment with baby cat, and then what else do we do? We open gifts, I guess. It's just a small order, because anyone who gives us anything has to send it overseas. So we got a few sleep phones, which was exciting. Both of us like to listen to music or videos or something when we want to go to bed. And I also, both of us snore, so it helps having something nice to listen to instead of snoring when you're trying to sleep. So we got sleep phones, a pair for each of us. What else? Oh, we got towels, which sounds like not exciting at all, but we have needed like tea towels ever since we moved here. It's just one of those things that you don't think of getting yourself, I guess, or at least we certainly didn't. So we got tea towels, which was, again, absurdly exciting. What else? Oh, we got a game for the Wii U. It was a Donkey Kong game, which husband had played, like the original Donkey Kong Country. And so this is the new updated one. And we had some fun. It has a co-op mode, so we were playing that a little bit yesterday. And other than that, we basically just relaxed. We had a lovely hot pot dinner, Chinese hot pot in our rice cooker. Just lovely. Oh, and I got the best Christmas gift I think I've ever gotten from husband. He converted our living room like coffee table into a kotatsu. And for aficionados of Japanese culture, you might know what it is immediately. But for those of you who don't, I grew up with my best friend growing up was Japanese, and in her house she had one of these. And basically a kotatsu is like a coffee table type thing, but it has a blanket over top of it, so when you have your legs under the coffee table, your legs are covered by a blanket. And underneath the blanket and the table is a space heater. So what happens is you have your legs and feet, and sometimes your whole body if you want, depending on the size, underneath this table and blanket with a space heater. And so the blanket keeps in the heat, and you turn on the space heater for a little while, and you get so warm and cozy, and you just basically have this, like, table blanket, and it's so warm and so nice. And husband converted our living room table into one of those, which I've wanted for ages. So we've been really enjoying the kotatsu. So when we're playing on the Wii, or we're watching movies or TV or whatever the case may be, we have just this awesome, warm, cozy place to do it. So I've been very happy. Husband's gift doesn't arrive for a little while yet, but he got a new laptop, which he has also needed for a really long time because his is crashing like several times a day. So we got him a really nice Alienware laptop. Oh, we're at the boss. Okay, oopsie daisy. And apparently we are, oh dear, he does a lot more damage than I remember. I think we want, no, run away. You can see the health bar on the top hand of the, oof. See, if you save your weapons, this is much easier. No! I died! I actually died! Ah! This is horrible. Okay, I'll have to try again. Oh, I guess you don't lose your weapons. I thought you lost your weapons. Oh, well, that's nice, at least. Okay, I still have a bunch of rockets. Hey. Oh, they do 2 damage. No wonder. I guess there's like a little hack. If you... Ah, that makes it easier. Oh. There we go. There we go. First boss complete. And thus endeth Christmas Chronicles. Alright, so that was a quick little video. Hope you enjoyed, and I will make some more soon. Until then, farewell.